My name is Peter Worlanyo, Abomah, a PhD student from Tesla American University. And my presentation is on student problems, locus of control, personality, and social support as predictors of counseling-seeking behavior of adolescents in senior high schools in Volta region, Ghana. Will you guide me in my slides, in the presentation, please? The study, hello, I'm online. The study will be organized around the summary, the problem statement, conceptual framework, related studies, methodology, results, and conclusion, as well as recommendation. So the summary or the abstract. The study investigated the role of student problem, locus of control, personality, and social support as predictors of counseling-seeking behavior of adolescents in senior high school in Volta region, Ghana. The specific objectives are to determine the correlation between student problem on adolescent counseling-seeking behavior, to evaluate the influence of personality in predicting counseling seeking behavior of adolescent, to determine the influence of, hello, can you control the slide for me? Yes, the continuation of the objective is to determine the evaluate the influence of personality in predicting counseling seeking behavior of adolescent, to determine the influence of social support in predicting counseling seeking behavior, to assess the role of locus of control in predicting counseling-seeking behavior, to justify the reason that prevents adolescents from seeking help from counselors, and possibility of gender differences in seeking help. Statement of the problem. Adolescent students in Ghanaian senior high schools are not accessing counseling opportunity that exists in schools. What is preventing them from this opportunity needs to be answered. Is it their personality type, their locus of control, or lack of social support? This needs an investigation comprehensively. The question that many ask is, how are adolescents able to manage the numerous challenges that they face if they are refusing to access counseling opportunity? Because that stage is a transitional stage where they need a lot of support if they have to sail through. Almost all senior high schools in Ghana have established counseling centers as part of educational reform in 1987 and 2002. The question then arises to be answered. Are students really making use of the facilities in schools? Adolescents in schools are faced with a lot of issues, which include teenage pregnancy, school dropout rates, high drug addiction and alcoholism, as well as other social problems. Problem statement further. There is a need to identify what prevents adolescents from seeking counseling and how this concern can be appropriately addressed. Systematic efforts to promote adolescent health seeking are essential for improving and promoting long-term psychosocial health outcomes. Conceptual framework. Two theoretical frameworks were found to be relevant to understanding of the content and method that is under investigation. That is Maslow hierarchy of need that has been defined and refined by Chapman in 2008, and the health belief model by Jean and Baker 1984. These were chosen to conceptualize the influences of the personality, locus of control, social support, and health-seeking behavior of adolescent students when attempting to resolve a range of counseling issues. In terms of related study, Rachel Dean and Wilson and Crouch Carochi 2005 indicates that Psychological help seeking involves communicating with others to obtain help and support from troubling experiences. They indicate further that seeking help and using social support are protective factors for many adolescent outcomes and generally display a greater prevalence from informal sources. This service gap in Ghanaian schools need to be filled. If it comes to related study like personality type and counseling, seeking behavior have been reviewed in the detailed work. Social support has been examined. The influence of gender on adolescent health-seeking behavior, locus of control theory have been reviewed. Self-esteem as a factor that influence adolescent health-seeking behavior, as well as stigma as a barrier to adolescent intention to seek help, have all been reviewed. Method. A correlational survey was the research design for the study. Stratified, proportional, and simple random were used to select 300 students for the study. The 218 questionnaires were retrieved for the study. 100 first-year students, 100 second-year students, and 100 third-year students, made up of 150 female and 150 male students in 6 selected schools in Volta region were selected for the study. The instruments that were used for data collection included standardized scale, 5 standardized scale, that is Big 5 Event 3, Rota Locus of Control scale, Self-Stigma of Health-Seeking scale, Multidimensional scale of Perceived Social Support Assessment, General Health-Seeking questionnaire, and Student Problem Inventory were administered. All these skills have their established reliability by the original developers, and then established crashback reliability have been established by the investigator. The results. 2 types of analysis were done, the preliminary analysis and the major analysis. In the preliminary analysis, it was conducted to summarize data in the form that could be easily interpreted. This included frequency of demographic characteristics of the sample, analysis of normal distribution of the variable, discrete analysis and correlation matrix among key study variables. Chi-square was also used to determine differences between groups in nominal factors. The next stage of analysis was to explore the distribution of data that were assumed to be in interval scale by nature. Though some were further converted to nominal data. Summary of means, standard deviation, skewness, ketosis, and reliability coefficient of the key study variable were presented in the analysis. 4 hypotheses were tested in the study. The 4 hypotheses concentrated on the correlation between separate predictor variables, student problem, personality, locus of control, on one outcome variable, that is help-seeking behavior. Multiple regression analysis would have offered an explanation on the prediction of the 3 predictor variables or 1 outcome variable. However, the sample size is not large enough for running the multiple regression analysis. However, multiple regression analysis was conducted to support the results of other equally relevant statistical analysis of prediction, such as partial correlation and Pearson bivariate analysis, which were conducted to test the 4 hypotheses. The conclusion indicates that there is a significant negative correlation between student problem and counseling seeking behavior. Personality of adolescent students will significantly predict their counseling seeking behavior. Locus of control of student will significantly predict their counseling seeking behavior. There is a significant positive correlation between social support and counseling seeking behavior. The finding and conclusion indicates that there is a significant correlation between student problem and counseling seeking behavior. Locus of control positively and significantly predict all the study variable except self-stigma or seeking help, which it predicts negatively. Significant correlation exists between social support and student problem and help-seeking behavior.